Hi guys, slightly later, it's midnight. We're gonna wait till the midnight grind. So we have a tantalizing situation in the Sunday challenge. We've won this twice before when there was more money to win. It used to be like 25k for first. Obviously they've flattened out the buy-ins. You usually get like 120k. Oh. Heck. Okay, great news. Scope's gone down. The holder manager's gone down. Okay, we are getting a tasty price, but we see where we are here. We're 76 out of 97. 90 paid is a $237 bubble. So we're very keen to finish the right end of that. Given that that to double that, you would need to get in the top 27. So it's definitely worth it. So we are unashamedly going to play a bit tighter, and I'm going to try and make that bubble. And then obviously we can open up because after the bubble, you know, the payments are less exciting. $20 jumps or $30 jumps initially, so that's okay. But quite a regular jumps. We've get this holder manager back. We played okay. We got quite lucky in a spot where we had pocket aces and someone went all in. We called, someone else called. We just called a trap, but it was like a 15 big blind all in or something. No, 12 big blind all in. And someone else called, and we went three way, and we had aces. It didn't work out. I think that's you know, we got two outed on the river, and that would have been for like 30, a 33k stack about an hour and a half ago. So as you can see now, you know, that kind of stack would is more than we, you know, it would have been incredible. And the dude had pocket tens, he needed two tens in the deck to hit, so it kind of like hit them both. It was very sad. It was a sad time, but we're okay. We'll get over it. It's an hour and a half ago we're mentioning it, so you can see how over it we are. So we are just taking our time a little bit. I know that makes us a bad person, but it is the it's a big bubble for us, and it will be a real black cloud if we somehow don't do it. 80 out of 97. It's gonna go so slow. Everyone has the same idea. Oh shit. Oh boy. And the littlest stack only has still has like four big blinds. Over this way, we've got our classic 5 rebuy 4k guaranteed. It's gone up to 5.2 today, 994, so 1k up top. We're 32 out of 58. We've done well, we've won it, and we've final tabled and deep ran last night. So last 3 days we finished first, 8th, 20th, you know, and see what happens today. You can see there's a pattern there. We're getting worse. So let's try and reverse that pattern. It's going to be hard. Oh, overall we'd obviously be jamming this. I'm not sure. I really hope someone opens so I can just fold, because we're quite threatening the big blind. It'd be gross to be sucked out on here, but we're gonna have to go for it. There we go. Don't cooler us! Do not cooler us! Don't cooler us! We're trying to be brave. we're trying to impress people. Don't cooler us. Don't do it, Ender. Don't be an East Ender. Be a Fold Ender. Yes! We got it through! We got it through! Whew! Guys, this is how tense it is, you know. We, like I say, we are a two-time champion of this, but those heady days. Last time we won this tournament was like a year and a half ago. It's heady days of January 2015. They're long gone. And we've had an unremarkable run for a little while. But we're starting to get back into it a bit more. Do better. Oh. So now... 95, 74 and 95, it's so important that we... Now the good thing about that is it kind of secures our place a little bit. It just would have been awful. What I'm trying to do is not shove, but like not quite go all in, because I think it just has a little bit more fold equity, actually. It looks a little bit more like I'm thinking about it. And also, look at this, how tight we are. I think that works in our favour when we do play as well, because it's like, this dude's been knitting up, and suddenly he's like, he's not quite all in. What the fuck's going on here? You know, we must have like jacks and be like, you know, they're going to assume I got like jacks and I'm just trying to, you know, take it down because I'm a bit scared of the bubble. Actually, I've just got sixes, guys. Just got sixes. He just been diddled. I've got jacks up here. Yeah, sure. At the top we've got this $12 1.2k guaranteed. It should go way over that guarantee though. And then we over this way we've got the $30 2.5k super turbo swordfish. And you see that that guy with the swordfish, he looks a bit like he's got a penis for a nose, but a very long and thin one, which would do an awful lot of damage to people. This guy free bets quite a lot. Flat because we are deep and it's early. So I think someone like Dean Eggs here, Daniel Agrani, I watched a couple hours of him play, and he would check back here on almost all boards. But we'd like to bet for value because we think there's a lot of bad turns to come. When he just snap calls like that, I think he might even have an ace high, ace king, and he's just trying to peel one quickly. Or even king queen or something like that, you know, something he's tried to free bet. We win. So we're going to open. It looks like we'd be opening more than normal because the small blind's sitting out, so it's a good defend from Ramiz. Should be defending a lot. Sorry, you can't see this one, it's just over here. We're going to see bet. Obviously, we're just slow folding in the Sunday Challenge, guys. Trying to get to the bubble. Then we'll chill out a bit. I promise. We just won't get re-raised. Just get this in early because I think he's got a jack, and we can flip here. Who's this here? He's got a jack, but we can just rebuy. It's quite early, and it's only a 5 2-ticket guaranteed. So I'd be quite happy to gamble and have a double up, or just pay another fiver to play another. You know, to rebuy straight away. It's frustrating when you get left with 40 chips. So we'll just get rid of those and go back to 3k. Because the run good required to make this chip in a chair back to 3k. We might as well use that to make like 100k with all the chips. Because that's the same equivalent sort of run good. 71th we are at a 93. 93, free to go. Oh my god. Just bust, guys, bust. And it's probably be all the sickos, all the fish will be knitting up, all the sickos will be like, I've got to exploit the bubble, dude. He's probably just free betting me like, just get it in, I just get it in. I'm getting it in. All that stuff, you know. We'll just defend the big blind with a ace high. Still be good quite a bit on this sort of board. Set Euros opened MP. see, but I think we will have to peel. So now we're basically repping that we have something, a jack or a queen. We're hoping he bets. So if he does have something, I think he'll bet again. And if he doesn't, I think he'll check back. Because if you look at it as well, even if we had 10-9, it would have got there on the turn. So I like his double barrel. He usually bets 58% on the flop, 39% on the turn. So we'll give him credit. Well played. He had a quiet confidence about him in that hand. Oh my god! 71th. Alright. Oh, so we'll just slow fold again, guys. I'm sorry, I know that is tilting to watch. But I really want to make the money. 92! One more time and it's hand for hand. First things first, we just want that cash. It means that the whole night is okay. It's funny enough, this min cash is worth more. We won that little $5 tournament yesterday. I haven't played it today because I'm just trying to concentrate more on this table and while it's there, you know, rather than mess around and have loads of small tables. Oh my god. I think it's making it worse because I made some stuff with chilies, so probably best not to put my eye on it. Oh, chili or chili eye now, red hot chili eyes. Where's that? What's happening? Oh look, I must have won when I put my 40 in. Oh my god, that's just terrible news. This re-raise, 40 hands, never free bet before. I think whatever's happening there, I think he had it. Brits are potato waffles. Waffle in versatile. Ee-oo. Ace 9 off suit. No. Let's get this in. I just want to get rid of this and have 3k, guys. Is that okay? Can you not let me run hot with this small stack? What a waste. And look, 92 still. The 75th dirt. You have to have erred, you know, for 73rd, but it's literally impossible to put the 73rd on the 75th. The 75th erred. Interesting, people can have some jacks. It's tempting to rep it. I think this early on, we're not going to try and rep it. We're just going to move on to a hand where we actually have something value bet it. That would be nice. Let's do something more sensible of our time. We ended up winning anyway with ace high as well. I didn't really mention that, but I didn't really think there was a huge amount of time we were going to win that. But I should have, because ace high was pretty good on that board, so I was an idiot. And look again, guys, look, we talk about how bad it is, just we don't want to have to do this. Imagine if we had 3k now, we'd have all the money. For sake. Whoa. Still 92. Who's the short stack? He's got hardly any of the short stack, guys. He's got hardly any. Oh. Oh, he's got, oh my god, is he sitting out? Oh yeah, let's have a look at him. Oh, he's sitting in, he is existing. Oh, well, sorry to be so excitable about this, but it's exciting, I love playing this tournament. I want to be a three-time champion, guys, and there's a lot of tough players playing it these days. They probably want to just three-bet me all day long, but I can pull out some moves. I've got moves, guys. I've watched some training videos. I watched some Chuck Bass today. That guy that pretends he's aggressive, but he isn't really. He's, you know, like, oh man, it's a six spot, and I could totally be doing this. And then people were like, post, and I've noticed this too, when you play with him, it's like, he's got super nitty stats. Oh, piss off! I think we have to actually make a fold here because people are so short, and it's just like, obviously we want to be aggressive and win this, but I mean, you can almost spike fold, spike call in the big blind, and we've got a 40% chance of busting. So as much as I want to jam this, I think we're gonna have to wait. For God's sake, I hate ICM, I hate the bubble, hate all the big bubbles, I hate the big bubbles, guys. Makes me a nervous wreck. I just want to fit in. Look, we keep winning. Look, we've gone from 30 chips to 1.2. It's just absolutely ridiculous. I don't want any part of this. It's hand for hand. Oh my god. I'm just going to fold. He's gone all in. Someone's gone all in. So he... Oh my god, someone's called. Oh. It's got ace king. We just need to hit. We would have hit a queen. Oh, for god's sake. That's the pain of it, guys, you know. And you don't make the right call, and you would have got lucky. But I guess you, I think we made the right decision. But we would have, if we'd have been boneheaded enough, we'd have like 60k now. Fuck. Shit. Can someone just bust, please? Fuck. Shit. Fuck. As you can see, guys, you know, we've got a very calm demeanor, very clear, rational approach. Oh. Oh. Oh, hi. Oh, come on. We're on the bubble. Oh, shit. That would have been so good. But you can see what would have happened is, though, we would have got our money in, and we'd had a 70% chance of being knocked out there on the bubble. So actually, it was the right decision. It just would have worked out, you know. I always feel, I don't know whether I'm getting more comfortable with it, but I always feel like when I make folds, that other people will be like, "Dude, you know, you're just gonna get run over or whatever." Like, it's not true. I don't get run over. I'm all right. I do okay. Dude's got fuck all. Get rid of him. Get him out of here. And Dublin's fair city, where the girls are so pretty, first set my eyes on sweet Raven Jetburn. As he rode his wheelbarrow through the streets, dude's got $907, but some stupid Swedish wrestling, you know. He, no offense to the, you know, but I'm just saying, some kind of aggressive, really tough aggressive player will get involved with another one, and they'll be like trying to out-sick each other because it's like a game of chicken to them on the bubble. Will that happen? Is that just happens in my mind? I don't know. The blinds are, look, the blinds are gonna 250. He's only got four hands until the ante, so the antes are 250. He's only got 907, so he's gonna be eaten up. It's just whether others bust first. So who's like the next last? Okay, tilt juice. He stayed in. Bloody hell, guys, I hate this. I hate to see for a fact that my ace queen would have sucked out. So it's like I knew for a fact that my thinking was correct to wait for the bubble as people to act. And someone jammed anyway. And we, you know, they're not going to have nothing there because it's near the bubble. But the way they jammed, you know, they can, like, they had pocket eights, they're kind of repping that sort of a hand, you know. Eights, nines, ace jack suited, ace queen, you know, ace king, those kind of hands. This guy's been quite aggressive. It's quite a lot early position, so we will flat. Obviously, generally, ace high would be pretty good here. This guy's pretty aggressive though, so we are going to get barreled off it quite a bit, so I probably will. Make a tighter fold. He's made it quite large as well, which is not really wrapping anything, is he? I shit this in his face. I don't think he's got anything. Wow. Wow. Cheers, mate. Nice hand. Oh, well, I made a mistake there. I feel like I felt really confident he just didn't have anything. Like he had queen high or another ace high or something that he had up to raise fold. Because why would he bet so much? He'd never have a 10. I mean, like, I guess pocket nine's the hand he had, like a pocket pair that was vulnerable to overs, you know, going, well, I'm going to go with it on this board. Maybe that is true. So we just spewed it off and won, which was nice. We'll make it slightly tight fold. He's got 400 now. Come on, dude. Is he going to get it in? People are going to wait for this. Guy, he's got an ante. He's folding again. He's folding again. We're just. I mean, I don't think we can play pocket aces the next hand. Because the value of I think we probably would actually. I don't think we can fold aces. What could we? I mean, I don't know. I'm not good enough to fold there. I understand the theory of it, but. I also want to win the tournament, you know. Look, this is classic stuff. You are bad. He's saying, you know, I want this pot. It's on the bubble, and I think you're just bluffing. What a great play. Well played. You are bad, lol. So he tends to slow down a bit on the turn, as most do. So we expect him to check back a decent amount. We think we have to call on a 10-6-2 with pocket sevens. Okay, that's interesting. Could have a six here and be doing that. So let's hope he checks back the river anyway. If he jams here, then you know we do have to fold. Unfortunately, it's sad. Oh my god, that's sad. You swines. Oh my god. Obviously I couldn't really play that one anyway in early positions, so. But see your swines anyway. A plague on your house. A plague of Craigs. A plague of people called Craig at your house. Has it happened? Have we made the... No. Shit, I thought we had. Oh my god. Alright, let's get this one in again. We're still trying to build that one up from nothing, aren't we? This guy again. Interesting turn. We can check call the river. He might try and bluff down the river, he seems quite aggressive. Yeah, he just had, he had a missed draw, so that's good. Lovely news. Here, pocket, ace 10, we got it open. Oh, sugar, still hand for hand. Where's that guy? Tilt juice is so low now, too. Where is the love? So this guy seems really like he'll bluff here quite a lot. So we'll try and induce him to bluff. It seems like he's there. We go. He does bluff. So we min raise to tilt him, get it in. You think he's got? Yeah, ace king seems reasonable. So we just got to avoid. There it is. Yes. Obviously we allowed him to be bluffing there. It was a flush draw and a straight draw. So I think his merit to just clicking it back. It's just incredibly frustrating for him to see a man click it back. You probably suspect that you're no good. He's all in. This dude is all in. Oh my god, I want to jam blind against blind, but I can't. Maybe if we try and wait it out, actually, if it folds around, because if we can see this guy goes, then we can. We will have to finish ahead of him, surely, if we bust after and have more chips. Oh, no! No! Well, that's going quite tight, so actually I think I wouldn't and no longer is it a fist pump jam at least. It's been a pretty solid player opening. He could get exploited here, Vicky, but see. Oh my god. This is the whole pathway of being that kind of bubble monkey. When we had these big hands before, we got two out on the river for a big pot, you know. And it would have made us, rather than a bubble monkey, we would have been, you know, a king on big stacks. 61k, 3 out of 114 in this. Can we win it two times in a week? I mean, assuming we count Sunday as the end of this week, which I think we probably do. Jesus, guys, oh my god. This stuff is real. You have a hand play. Just how many more spots are we going to have to fold? Listen, blood, yeah? I'm appealing to you out there. How many spots are we going to fold just to get into the money? That's what I sacrificed. Sacrificed that for you, blood. Invader Max. Quite a tight player. Price is too good. We need a two or a king. That's not really very good. We didn't do it. I'm quite tight, but I feel like the price is good. And that sways me. Sake. He's in! This guy Brunovic is all in under the big blind. I think he knows he'd be out next time. He's been called. I love it. Why does he have to ice it? Just let a few people come along. Let's really get this guy out of here. Oh my god, Pat Brooks. Go on, Pat. I think maybe, yeah, this is the thing. The good players quite like to extend this pain for the rest of us. So that's when you know that you're a high level player, when you want the bubble to keep going, which is so good. This is good news though, at least stuff's happening. I'd love it if this guy floated and then we got two seeing the flop. I'd love that, I just love it. Go on. Yes! Okay, that's a flop that could help any of them. It's indiscriminate. I'd much prefer a texture that crushed them. God, it's so tense. Please. Yes! We made the money! Great, Reiso! Oh, yes. Alright, so we made the money now, so we don't have to be handcuffed quite so much. And we're not just going to get it in stupidly. We're going to wait. We've got eight big blinds, so we're not going to wait. We need to get it in, obviously, but we're not going to be stupid. We made the bubble, that's the first stage complete. Obviously, when you become the bubble monkey and you're doing that stuff, it doesn't feel very nice. But you just gotta do it. You gotta suck it up, kid. Could have had 60k, but instead we got this. So if it folds around, we get this in. That's the first stage of bubble rules. Bubble is broken. Bubble has broken, like the first bubble, like words have spoken. This guy's been super tight, so that's freaking me out, so we'll just fold too much. Okay. So we'll just get this in. Come on, A7, don't be as bad as you look. Get it through. See, we've freaked him out again. Okay. Oh, we got the same hand, okay. Both flop a 7. Oh, God, see, he's not scared of my play. He understands. I think oh, I'm not scared. Oh, okay, we didn't go backwards. Forward slightly. 9 big blinds. That's progress. 1 big blind at a time. Absolute pleasure to bink this one if I could do that. Oh, for God's sake! piss off. Sorry, you had to see that, guys. The way it is sometimes. Alright, Thomas wants to gamble. He's quite tight, so we're not going to gamble with him. No, Thomas. You're too nitty. Why the player there? We are looking to gamble, but don't want to take bad. No, the gambles are obviously behind, and that's no fun. Is it? That's near fun. That's nice. Ender's, you know, struggling because we don't want an Ender to do well because he's a good player. So we want him to fail, so he's not there at the end. So this is our hand as well. As long as a tight player doesn't open under the gun, then I think we're getting this in. He does just jam under the gun. It's been really tight, so I think we are going to make a tight fold. Some people would still get that in. Nothing wrong with getting that in at all. Seven big blinds. Go with it, I think. Oh, I'm gonna fold. Oh, God's sake. Oh, hey, poker. Oh my God. I'm gonna regret it, whatever I do. Shit, and then we'll look at two crappy hands and think, fuck, what are we doing? Three. It makes me feel better if he would have sucked out. So that's good. We would have been sucked out on there. We'd have less chips, so not to be results orientated, guys, but it's some comfort to my tight fold. It's 81 now, so we've made, but now made a 255, which is going to put us, you know, put us kind of. Just slightly worse than break even, maybe overall by the end. Once we've bought all the other stuff in we're going to play, then maybe we're still down 100 or so. But right now, that breaks us even. But we're looking to win 17k here. 17.1. We're looking to be a three time champion. And only then, you know, will the Pokemon really take us seriously. And maybe we'll be able to have a successful life rather than the shadow existence that I'm currently inhabiting. Alright, new people next to us. Let's hope that we've got some fish next to us. So we've got quite a good table overall. Could be a lot worse. One, six, four, two. Okay. So this guy plays kind of high, maybe high on drugs. He's down 22k. I'd imagine he's going to be like one of those kind of aggressive handfuls. Alright, so I can't like raising here because you can have a lot of draws. I'm not going to want to drop his draws yet. Drop his draws, guys. You see what I did? We could definitely call and induce him to bet the turn and then get in on the turn as well. So I think my standard probably is to call and then let him do it on the turn, but this particular time we just had that Jack 10 feeling. And, you know, obviously he has a range of hands, not just one hand. We have that Jack 10 feeling. Do we ignore that feeling? I don't think we do. So we're just going to shut this down on the river and hope on the turn and hope that he just... There we go, that's fine. Sorry guys, you probably can't even see all that, but just a, you know, your standard kind of hand. So he made it quite big like that. So we just flatted in position rather than 4-bet. Remember, we don't even have a pair yet. But here, my God, it's getting very late in this tournament. Cheery me. 7 big blinds, do people have to jam that? God, that's just painful. So we just flat in position. We get the top pair and we just decide to go straight ahead and re-raise rather than kind of let check call again. Just because we think, oh, he has a lot of draws here. Alright. So we've got a hand. Fold, 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 and then we get this in. Come on, good play. Actually, we'll get it in anyway now. Just going to freak him out. Hope he doesn't have ace king. Let's hope he has something we're doing well against. No, he's got king's ace! Guy ace! Ace! Hold for me! 2! Yes! Yes! Let's do this! Oh, an ace jack blind against blind. He's going to be so mad. We can limp in here and check. Oh, wow. Good one. We're going to re-ISO Ender's jam if he jams. Whew! Okay, he's trying to do my trick. That's my trick, guys. Hey! Hey, guys, that's my trick. See, the thing is, guys, when you're a trailblazer, eventually the regs will catch up. Alright, okay, I don't like it anymore. I think we're going to muck ace-jack. This is sketchy. I haven't even scoped this guy. So we're just going to fold. It's just tantalising board. What did he have? So we would have got it in good, actually, and we would have ended up getting sucked out on, because I don't think he's going to fold if we re-ISO, but maybe he would. But it seems like when you put 9k in, you're going to end up getting like 2.5 to 1 on your call, then he's probably not folding. Woo-wee! What a rush! What a rush! Alright, we're gonna do it, guys. We can do this. It's gonna be... If we don't win this, I'm gonna be sad, okay? We have made the money. That's good. And the funny thing is, the very first thing that happened, we bought him for the 5k about an hour in, and we had about 20 big blinds or whatever, and the guy with like 15 big blinds jams, just jams, cut off, and we call him a big blind with pocket tens because you know, and he has ace ten and hits an ace, so we end up being down like with 1,500 straight away, and like 7 or 8 big blinds or whatever. But we get back into it, get back in, kid. Okay, so we're just climbing the money as well as we wait, which is nice. Holy moly. Weird spot, isn't it? Let's try and min-raise. We might get some action from this guy. I'm not sure what we're going to do. We're pretty deep, isn't it? So we want to call up 50 big blinds, get 50 big blinds in. But we feel like we're decently ahead of his range, for sure. We shall. Alright. Interesting, isn't it? Right, we're just flat. We could just get it in there. Oh, he's in a 3-bet pot! Okay, normally bets, does he? Alright. So we're going to try and bet, but I think we want to... If he's going to check there, then I think we should bet, because I think he might well have a queen. He might be strong. But he's not. That's fine. Could check back. Kind of nice to know that he will just check fold to us when he misses. I didn't really expect him to be a check folder, guys, so I felt like it's actually pretty good to bet that flop, even though... you know, you might think, oh, I better let him catch up. But a lot of the things that catch up aren't good news, really. So I like just betting there. Interesting. So he must be down the money then, that guy, to have that rating with those many hands. So he's down a lot of money, probably 100k, probably, or something. It's crazy. So we're really down short in this, so we have to get in this ace for real. I don't know why we haven't done that previously. So we'll just make a big single raise. It looks a bit like an open to people that aren't concentrating. Obviously on a Sunday a lot of the regs won't be fully concentrating, but just see me open and fold. Big blind obviously is concentrating, well played. And he's getting rewarded. He's been rewarded for his concentration. We have outs. It's not one of them. So we are out of the turbo swordfish. We let ourselves get a bit short in that, I think, just concentrating. And it's a turbo, you know, these turbos are a bit turdy, aren't they? Turgids. What we really want to do is scope this Dominic chap. Oh, Dominic, Dominic, 8-8-8, Dominic. He's trying to suck up to 8-8, but he's actually a losing player again. He's a guy that plays high and loses money. Good. Not to just, you know, we need these, in the nicest way, we need these people. These are our people. We're obviously getting this in. Oh, Dominic, I see you. Okay. Opened a bit wider, flatted. Okay. Adjusting sizing. Take a note of it all, freeway. Does see bet. Check calls the turn. Check. What? Check calls the turn. What's going on? Alright. Got mesmerized by that, sorry. Is that check call on the turn just freaked me out? You know what the fuck was going on? Sorry guys, didn't mean to swear at you. Swear in your faces. Grey Monk in the house. Can't help it, Grey Monk. Got a hand. I assume you've got a hand too. Hence why it's happening. I've got to have a better hand. I mean, my range is... Alright, let's just focus on this. Oh my god, what a big open. He's got such a big stack now as well. You bugger, Grey Monk. You bugger. I haven't got any idea about this guy, so we are going to make a tight fold, but in a general situation like that, we are going to jam. But he's just nearly 3x's it. He's got some big stack. I want to just watch him a little bit, make sure that he's really doing it that frequency in early position before I just commit myself. This guy's really tight. I hope he doesn't open, because I want to re-jam this one. I want Dominic to open. Go on, Dominic. Guitar's been really aggressive, but I think we would call a jam, because he can't be that strong when he snap jams like that, you know. I think he's going to have... Alright, we fold now. Two all-ins. Oh my god. Are we playing a different game? What's happening here? He's got... I mean, I can't believe he... Oh, that's good. So we would have lost. That's good. Home to both of them. But we were ahead. This guy did an aggressive thing and re-ISO'd late in this tournament, which is pretty hardcore. That's fine. So we've got 292 and it's 320 for the last 54. So it's just a nice gravy train of caches. We want to just savour it, enjoy it, and then we're going up to 45. Okay, 365, the last 45 is all exciting. I don't mind having a tight image, just maybe we'll get a few more folds through in general. We have been playing quite tight here, 898, so we've just, obviously a lot of that is the bubble where we were very much handcuffed. We did make a tight fold with the sixes. But as you can see, he hasn't actually, it's not like he's raising every hand. You look at this, with no history, and you see a guy with a big stack, with a donkey, and you think, you know, this dude is probably going to be opening loads. But if you look at it closer, his average buy-in is quite low, 26. He's only played 400 games, ability 56. So he's been quite expressive with his open, in terms of sort of, you know, he's, it's kind of like it's meaning something. He's being expressive, and he's sort of shaping his range when he's so expressive with his sizing. R-E-S-P-E-C-D, don't know what it means to me. R-E-S-P-E-C-D, R-E-S-P-O-C-D. I don't really like this sort of hand. It's one of those hands that doesn't play so well post flop and has a lot of reverse implied oddage to it. We've got our last now. We've still got 10 big blinds. That ain't so bad. Typifies tight image. We're going to be obviously getting it in general. Get rid of that now. Just start a new one soon. I'll do that, I think, and keep playing that one. It's so hot today. I played football. Boy, it was hot. Okay! Here it goes, guys. Here it comes. Here comes the pain storm. Go! Come on, fives! Come on, fives! Do this for me. Don't bust. We don't need no busting. Just, if you're going to call, you've got to have a lower pair or an over cards that don't hit. Don't do it to me, Dominic. Come on, Dominic. All the time we've known each other. No! It's going to be that idiot Dominic. Idiot from... Where is he from? Oh my god. It's oh god. Okay, we're in a flip. 2-2-2! 5! We've got to hold! 5! Quad fives! We've got a quad fives! Here we go! It's happening! Who wants to be a three-time champion? Raven Jet Burn does. Can I be a three-time champion, please? It's all I've ever wanted. I just want to be a three-time champion before the prize pool gets so small that it's not worth bothering with. God, that's good. We rode it out in the bubble. Oh, woo! Yeah, don't worry, Abby. It's a good kind of mad. Abby's worried. I think that it's a bad kind of mad. Just explaining that it's a good kind of mad. That was exciting. What a rush. Alright. Doing it. Got a nice 5 minute delay on my stream now, so I'm pretty sure that I feel better that people couldn't watch it and wait a while. I had a thank you Mickey for the heads up on that. He said they tanked a while and you could see my pocket sixes in a certain spot. Must have been weird for him. But it's nice that he told me. That's the sort of camaraderie that I feel poker should have. But it seems to get a lot scummier. What about this blind against blind? I almost want to limp call and induce a rejam from Crystal Mad. I think that he'd be tempted to re-raise us if we limped blind against blind. Oh, Dominic. Ooh, I think the problem is that Dominic seems a bit pissed. Like he might spike call with an ace 10. Ooh, do we just ship this 20 big blinds? God, I'm so tight. God. If we look at this table, it is actually pretty good. We've got Crystal Mad next to us, who's a tough player. But then we've got three weaker players, we reckon. Three weaker players this side. Some of them kind of high stakes weaker, where they're playing like average buy on 200, but they're down 20k. I mean, some of those guys might have made lots of money on PokerStars and they're just running bad. Over a relatively small sample, or whatever, you know, that kind of thing, variance, because the edge is small. +5/1, +4k. I think that guy's going to be good. Oh, wowee! Just incredible news. That was an emotional drain. You just want that to happen. We just want to keep going though. We want to get the stack going. I love to build a stack. I tend to find when I've won the challenge and the two... I don't know if I've mentioned it, guys, but I've won it twice. I don't know if I've mentioned that. 20 is a bit more money when I did it, guys. The stakes are a bit higher, literally. It's fine, though. So this guy's good. I've mentioned it, but I haven't. When I did, I usually kind of came from behind a little bit, you know? Where, got here, ace 8, we just fold. So what's going on here then? Oh my lord. We're going to get re-jammed on here, so we've got to decide, are we going to call a re-jam or not? Because that's what's going to happen. Oh my god. Okay. We are going to re-jam, because this guy's got a big stack. Come on, let's do this! Oh my god. No! Spade! Spade! Spade, guys! Spade for me! Spade! Yes! Come on! Yes! Give me those chips! Give me the chips! I need the chips! I need the chips! Give me the chips! Oh, boy. Oh, boy. The neighbours are going to think, what the fuck is happening? Just Raven Jetburn trying to become a three-time champion. That's all.
Oh, wow.
Sorry guys, what's going on in this? I'm disorientated for the other tables, we're just going to fold. Shit, that was a rush. What a rush, 21 out of 50. Oh,
I really want it to happen.
Shit, that would be nice. God, we've just moved tables as well. That's incredible. 22 out of 50 at this point. Wow. So nice. I haven't had a decent run in a challenge for a while. Normally when I don't have a run for a while, it ends up being this one, and I end up winning it. So the police aren't called because there was a disturbance at Burn House. This guy's a little bit up and down. Interesting. Just keep that blank for a moment. Caramel's back. He's been quite tight, Caramel, if I remember rightly. Fish moth badge. Seems very active. He's a fish, he's a bad aggressive fish. That's great news. Look at this, $130 average buy and around 30k. UK and everything, I'm not repping it very effectively for the UK. I had to rejam, that would have been a gross bust just before the break. I was almost tempted to kind of wimp fold it, but instead of limp fold, there's a wimp fold, you get what I'm saying. But we didn't wimp it out, we rejammed, we had to. Average buying 300, okay. Plus 4k. So it's going to be doing well. 293. He's a tough one. So already this is probably a tougher table. But just having two. But I hope that's his stats. No, someone else's. Okay. I'm gonna say if those were his stats, then I mean he was playing too tight. That would have been better for us. This guy reckons he's gonna be a fish. Minus 10k though. So. Make a little cup of tea. Just trying to calm myself down a little bit.
bit crazy there.
We're gonna gamble. Just need a 9. Close. 8, 9, 10, jack. Close. We've got 42 big blinds now, that's very nice. I'm gonna have 42 big blinds, a nice cup of tea. And the ability to make a free time champion out of ourselves. Okay, I'm back. We'll just fold there. It's quite aggressive, so we could have a competitive hand. Oh, maybe not. There's his stats. Yeah, it's actually pretty tight. Oh, powerful stuff. Do you think this guy's going to be good? So we'll give him that. This guy's been pretty tight actually. We'll give him a tight winning player. Bob has been too tight, maybe that's what's the problem. This guy's been very good. We're just gonna make a quite a tight fold.
A lot of sickos at the table.
We've got to be thinking very carefully about what we're opening in early position, because that can be a real leak for us, playing three bet pots out of position or raise folding. We want to have hands that we can continue with. Caramel, we think, has been pretty tight. We don't have a very playable hand, so overall we're just going to make a fold here. It's going to be pretty solid. We're happy just to pick decent spots. Not doing too marginal. Obviously we're not shying away when it's correct to do something, but we earned the right 40 big blinds to be a bit selective as well. Sorry about that, guys. We're back. Okay. with flop, got an over and a backdoor flush, backdoor straight. We'll just check. Could bet. And get a good turn. Now we're going to bet, should be getting value from any ace, should be calling here. Steal some draws that can call as well. I think this player might well have led, say, a flush draw on the flop. It wouldn't lead 10-8. They have nothing. That's what we thought. Look at this. Are we? What's he reckon? It's 100k out there. It's got. Makes the fold. Let me just do this for you. So, I'm going to be happy to show down an ace high here. If you had like queen high, you might want to try and bluff. I think you probably wouldn't, because you'd feel like you're going to get called by an ace high on a bet for a bet here. If you bet big enough, then it makes it interesting. That's a good bet, because in the enormity of this tournament, it's a hard bet. It's a hard call now with ace high. I think you have to make it. Well, be good. I mean, obviously he has to have a 7 or a 9 or pocket 5s. Pretty narrow. There we go. So he tried to turn king high into a bluff, and the tank of kings there, I would have been calling with ace high, and ace high would have been good. And so remember, guys, we're trying to pick up reads on the tables, and that was a good read right there. That's the kind of Lou reads we need. It's opening again. So it's been a bit more active on this table, but overall it's been very tight. So we think he still has a pretty strong hand. He's also betting out of flow a bit, because he's been a bit active, so I'd say that Karama has a really strong hand here. Maybe pocket queens, say, to pluck one out of the air. And he had ace 10, so he raised cooled pretty, so that basically he isn't that wide now anymore. So he's been playing, he's upped his game a bit. So we have to give him a little bit more credit, a little bit less credit in general. So we adjust our credit range. Obviously it's late, people are going to be, the good players that want to try and press on here and concentrate, rejam, free bet, you know, really deal with the cool stuff. All the fun stuff. Let's seem to follow 10 hands in a row. Could open this. Excuse me. We could open this, but we're going to fold. Jimmy man. Seems pretty competent, decent player. So this Norman Ollie played aggressive when he played. I feel like he's going to defend a lot, so I'm going to fold. We're only seven handed, so it's a lot closer. Straight. What does he have? A 10? He had pocket queens. Wow. Okay. We've got a playable hand. I think the stack size we have, I'm going to like to defend a lot. This guy's been quite tight. I flats. But I think we're too deep to rejam really anyway, so just cool. Missed the board. We'll take our time. It's a dry board. Be a great spot to raise, wouldn't it? Interesting turn. The raise would have worked, you know. Hard against this whole range, it's pretty good to be raised, check raise there. It'll be tough when he calls, and if he's floating, then it's going to make it hard for us. It's going to be hard for us to keep barreling. If we barrel that turn, Turagay. All right, Turagay. We like this turn a lot, so we'll bet it for value. We call with some ace highs and some draws. I'm going to try and value him against ace high there. Let's see, and oh, we actually had a 10, so we kept it as like a blocker bet as well. Wow. Okay. Let's see this hand now. Is Caramel kind of one of those slightly psychotic Swedes? Flat. Okay. A6. Wow, and he had trip jacks on the flop. So guess what? Don't think my raise would have worked. Jeez. And in fairness, if we re-raised and he cold called or whatever he did, well, you know, we wouldn't be happy at all. We would give up. Because it has a lot of strength. It would be a sick float. We play tight, we'd be repping it with a good image. Over 40. I feel like we're timing the run nicely. Just room for a double up about now. Oh yeah, I love it. Love all this. Exciting times. Great turn for a civil bet. Okay. Okay, 31 big blinds. I quite like just re-jamming. He seems a bit erratic, like he might call with like pocket nines or something. So let's just jam. 31 big blinds. It's on the bigger side, obviously. But that's okay too. No showdown. I think when we do that, we actually look like we have eights or nines, rather than jacks. I think he's capable of calling with smaller pairs. That's why I really like it. And I think he's capable of folding king queen. For good reasons. And he's opening, you know, he's got a big stack, he's going to open a lot. So he can't have the nuts all the time. We could just free bet. I think there's going to be a decent amount of flops we don't like. We have to play as an aggressive player. We will be in position. And certainly it will be profitable. And you could argue it's a better line. For sure. It's opening a lot now. 23 out of 39. Okay. Play this. As well. We've got other stuff happening. You could argue we shouldn't do that. I'm gonna do it anyway. Okay. Defends the big blind. Seems pretty standard and reasonable. He takes one off. Scary turn for them. Very scary river, or a good river for a lot of their ranges. Their checking ranges, they love that river. No! King high good. Caramel reined it in and got punished. Bad timings. Chill out. So tense. It's a tight fold as well. Okay. in tens. Gonna flat here, play post. Obviously, we give ourselves these tough boards. Interesting turn. Pretty terrible turn because he checks back a lot of aces on this board. So that's a bad turn for us. Definitely, when he opens up big, he has a lot of ace king and ace queen. There's a lot of pairs. I think the pairs would bet more, so I think by now we bet, we probably have to fold. Played. Definitely see us free betting there and getting him to fold maybe ace queen offsuit. But we took that low variance route, as the Americans would say, the route. So we look a bit vulnerable. We wouldn't want to open this now, straight away after. Probably better to free bet. I was a bit worried that we're not going to get it in good that much and only really flipping. I think he's a good player, and when we free bet there, we rep a really strong range. So he's going to toss away nines and below. Still getting jacks plus, sadly. We can't have tens because we've got tens. That's unlikely. Just going to flat here as well. A little short, a bit weak to free bet. This could over rep our hand, but we're just see a lot of flops. That's not a bad flop. Augusto Perez obviously has aces in his range. If he can two barrel us, he'll probably get us off a jack. But not for one barrel. Give us a jam here, it's a very dry board, I think we'd have to fold. A few checks back. No point in betting the river. We will take a bet check bet line with an ace as well sometimes. So we do beat whatever he had. Queen 9. That's the thing, it freezes them up when you call there. If they don't have an ace, I think they kind of give up. Still 39 left. Okay. Wow, we. What just happened? I think he rejammed. What's going on? What's just kicked off, guys? Bluff late Sunday challenge. We know you. We know what you're about. Hand for hand. Out of 55 in that. It's about 17 times smaller, sure. So this is an interesting one. I think again we make a tight fold. I think the most similar hand we play is King Queen suited, we would open. The reason being we've got aggressive nature going on late on. It's volatile. We feel like it's a place you can get a lot of leaks. 27 big blinds is not a lot. Not a good stack to be opening that kind of weakness late on. No longer hand power play. Kings. Hello, kings. I'm the king. I'm a Jesus-y king. You're a kingy king. King. Just call pocket eights this tournament. Good turn. Gonna fold. So this is an interesting thing I'm gonna do. I'm gonna re-raise now, because I think that we really freeze him and make him very honest. Get a free river a lot. Freeze him. We could probably get queens or kings to fold now, potentially, or pocket nines or tens, but we've got enough showdown just to check. And we have trips. Not played. We kind of check raised the wrong, you know, the wrong guy, I guess, but I don't mind it. Oh no. Poison chalice of kings. No one's leaving. There we go. Prophetic Tard is gone. Nice name, buddy. Keep thinking positive. Five big blinds. Still going. It's gonna be hard fought. I think that much is obvious. Opening that ace king, is that any surprise? I'm not reinventing the wheel here, I'm just opening ace king. With that little bit of extra juice on top of the min raise, oh yeah, classic stuff. If we get a flat, a good player here would often flat these days. Do we go for two in a row? I think we do. I think we do. We've been tight, we suddenly opened, and now we're opening two in a row. Hang on a minute, this guy must have a really strong hand. Shh. Don't tell them. Oh, we get a cool. Now this guy was tight. And get a fold here, but he does fold some of his range on this board, but not all of it. So he jams on us. That's a shame. We just fold. Didn't work out, did it? We tried to be cool. We tried to be like one of the kids and open an ace three. Didn't work out. So that's what happens when you're 33. You don't. It doesn't work out how you think it does, kids. I tell you. except for my attempt to be three-time Sunday Challenge champion. That's going to work out. Maybe not. I don't know. We'll see. We'll see. And this guy's capable of it. He's aggressive. So we'd love to induce some value from him. I think he'll view us as quite tight though and be cautious with us, which is a shame. So we'll just try and excuse me. Just try and get Sarah to bluff. He's not bluffing. Try and get some value on the river. Could argue we should just jam the river because is it a king is probably calling. Could hero a smaller bet with an ace high though. That's why possibly a six. Well, definitely a six or a seven with the size as well, I reckon. Bloody hell, mate. Bloody reckoning, mate. So, he calls. What did he have then? He did river a king, so that portion of the range we'd want to just jam and he'd call. But if you think about the overall portion, I did like our analysis. I think that there is a subsection of smaller ranges. The ace, sixes, the sevens. Things like that. These two have got a real image now, and I think Caramel's thinks, well, I've got chips now, I don't really want to duel with you so much. But we're getting down to that 20 big blind, we're getting shorter. We're going to change, there's going to be one less table soon, so maybe we'll change, maybe they'll add a couple to our bit. Hard to know. Interesting, tempting to rejam this, but we're just going to fold. I think the spot looks bluffy, so he might call a bit lighter with a king queen or something. As if we played it in a different position, we'd get a few more folds from him. Get out of the small blind, say. Keep an eye on what people are doing because it's free information. So we pick up aces, we're going to obviously re-raise it. And what about here? We just want to keep an eye on what's happening. So Lynx is being quite aggressive, he looks like an aggressive player. We don't have a proper tag on him yet, I think that's probably because of Sharkscope locked. Oh no, it's just a small range of. Doesn't play much. I'm going to try and raise his king dry. I mean, we could just call or whatever, but I think we stack off a king. That's not great news for us. This is Elliot. What is this? This feels like a set, doesn't it? What's going on? So Elliot is a fish, so I think we are just going to get this in. So I think you can do this with kings. No, he did have two pair. Ah, well played, sir. Oh, yeah, he played it that way. Oh dear. Could have got away from that one. It was a close one. I think if I'd have scoped him and he looked competent, then I'm pretty much always folding. What put me off is that he looked like a donkey, and donkeys can do that with ace king there, they can do it with king queen, believe it or not, but not as, you know, still borderline. Damn it. Oh. So much to ponder. 20 big blinds getting tight for us now. Blinds have gone up, the price of poker has increased. Our palms are sweaty, you know, we're still reheating our mum's spaghetti. We're not. I make my own spaghetti, guys. Not from scratch. but I think he's implying that there's bolognese attached. So in that respect, I do make a bolognese. That's the implication. So we're 30 out of 36. We've got $411 guaranteed. So we're kind of reaching 35 now. There's 457 for the last 27. In the last 18, 600, 800. Getting a grand for 10 to 12. I mean, that is like an annoying failure, which is still really nice. And look at this final table. This is just, you know, we'd love to get to this final table. 1.2k, 2k, 3k for 7th, 4k for 6th, 5k for 5th, 7k for 4th, 9 for 3rd, 12 for 2nd, and 17 for 1st. To get there, we have got to try and play our best. We've got to try not to wimp out too much, because at the same time, we are going to. Is it almost like a. You know, I watched this Negreanu video of him playing the tournament. It really hammered home how much more he values his tournament life. You know, I think it's when you multi table, you tend to want to maximise your value. And there's a few spots where I think a good player. And I've kind of always had the perception that, you know, a good player would agree that get a bit more value there. This guy, so he's not really trying to scare us off. We are going to call, though. He's very aggressive, so doesn't have to have it. But we do think that's slightly more odd what he's done. Oh my lord! There they are. There's the aces, and there's that raise from this aggressive player. Someone else play! Oh, I think we can set up a rejam from someone else if we flat, so we're gonna do it. Come on, Nemkis! Come on, come at us! Come at us, my friend! Oh my god, this is a great spot. Come on, Lynx, this is a great spot for you! Oh my god, no. This is an interesting dry board. It's quite big here. Oh my god, what a crazy turn. I hate that turn. I think, hoping he's got an overpair like pocket tens here, pocket jacks, and we're nice and clean and safe from all that board. Would he have bet 7, 17k maybe? We've just got to. We can check the turn actually. Oh my god! I think it looks like we have a pair that isn't an ace. He could bluff jam here, it's a great spot. We're trying to get value, and like look like we could, he could fold to a jam. It looks like we're trying to bluff him off this. Wow, could he read this as a bluff? It looks like we're trying to set him up like we could fold for the last 30k if he jammed. And he might have to hero call with less. Oh, it's a great spot we put him in. Oh, how can we still lose to quad sixes, guys? But I don't think he ever has that when he plays this slowly. But he could play it slowly, but surely he would just bet the river and hope to get a call. Yes, we take it down, we've got more chips. That's right, that's nip power for you guys. High powered nip power, yes. We just wait for our spots and we take the spots. We did induce some bets from him as well, guys, if you think about this. Imagine if we, you know, just to re-jamming, I mean, we're not having to be so worried about protecting our hand, and we're not thinking that people are just going to flat. They're going to make us make a play or not. So when we just call, we induce this big C bet. We just flat, because it, and then when we check back the turn, we induce a little river bet, and we just do that. I guess that maybe it's better just to jam the river. It just all depends on how you think about it. For some reason, I felt like, in retrospect, that looks really strong. But in my head, in that moment, I was thinking that was okay in some way. I'm wrong. I don't wanna talk about it, how you broke my heart. If you stay here just a little bit longer, if you stay here just
done.
Beautiful. Beautiful. Playing in my room. So he's played. It looks like he's going to be a good player. Yeah, he does look quite solid, quite decent. So let's reassess. So we're 23 out of 33 now. And remember, guys, no one saw our hand there. Unless they're watching this, they didn't see our hand. Oh, I just want to be a three-time champion, guys. Is that so much to ask? An old reg like me. Just trying to keep my back straight to learn. This is apparently good. It makes me look a bit weird. Hi. Well, blinds have really gone up since I was in town. So we're going to open. Been quite tight, so we should get credit when we open. Always trying to think about how you view, how your image is viewed before you open. So if a tight player does this, then he's just flattened maybe, you know, ace 10, ace jack, or something like that, you know, that maybe has us beat. When this guy rejams, snap rejams, I think we have to fold now. I think he's got a stronger hand. We could be flipping against pairs or, you know, ace queen maybe. But, alright, so here, get raised. Really repping that six, isn't he? We're just gonna hero him just because we have top pair, and we feel like he probably has it, but we just double rebind. He might just be spewing out in the rebind. Yeah, and he had king six, so he actually did have it. It kind of felt like he probably did. I think, you know, that was in the challenge, could have made that lay down. But when you're trying to double up, then I think you've got to be brave. Whoa, there, that would have been an interesting board for us. Look at us loving our idiot end. Just fold. About here, we've made the money. I think there's no harm in seeing a flop. This guy's pretty aggressive. We need to kind of go value. We can't really go bluff. Is this strong enough? Yeah, I'm gonna just jam here. There's a lot of money out there. We got a pair, and they need, you know, a lot of club draws drawn. We're not cool. We're not losing to them. You know, we're in a flip. Obviously, they might have a slight advantage with overs as well. Well, there we go. So he actually did have it. We could have outs, but no. That's a shame. A good check from him, because I would have probably been discouraged by a bet. Well played. We bust that. Which is a bit disappointing. I'll make this really big. Play it like that. How does that feel for you guys? Is that okay? Some kind of cage of tournaments closing in on us. Just fold. Weird, so maybe we'll have it like that. You just can't see this table so well. You still see it quite well, not so bad. let's try and pay attention, zone in, get reads. That's what we need to do. I'm going to probably eat a bit of curry. I really want to try and time it so I don't ruin my own concentration. Forgot to do my lovely spiced cauliflower with it. That was a shame. Is it too late to do that? If it's 40k, Binkosaurus rejams, and he's got a set of fives, and there's the river. Whoa, there! Whoa! Incredible stuff. Could arguably jam here. Suited, I would have jammed. Ace five suited. So this Nemekis is a very good player, so we don't really want to sort of tangle with him too much. Quite happy to get down to the last 27 and see how it shakes out. Obviously, if we have a nice spot, we've got 32 points, so we are slightly more comfortable in this tournament than. Yeah, we are that guy. And we've got pocket 10s, we're jamming 10s. Get it through with the tens, it seems. This is what happens, you see, when you're trying to spice cauliflower, you can end up losing the challenge. Look at this trippage on the river, trippy trips. Really supply some small cauliflowers as well. Quite disappointed about that. Oh yeah, we're going to make a call. We feel like it's flippy a bit like that, but we don't mind busting because we've got this big tournament. So we're going to take a bit more of a, you know, take a bit of a aggressive route in that tournament. Doesn't bother us too. It suits us to have just two tables now. Really focused. We might still sneak in a couple of other tournaments. We don't know who the big blind is now as well. And Caramella's really opening up. Very nice play. Very nice. We have to get it in with this hand over here. We're getting it on the shorter side. But at the same time, if you look at our... We might be relatively on the shorter side, but it means that the tournament's playing nice and deep at this stage, because we've got 32 big blinds, and for MTT tournaments late on, that's pretty big. You know, certainly not too bad. Diamond on the river. There's a diamond! I think we win that. Yeah, we do. Our short stack is still alive and well, so that's, you know, some niceness for us. Let's go, Ron. Have we missed anything? Oh. The problem is here, guys, I'm probably going to anticipate folding because if it folds around, I know that seems very tight, but it's because of Nemekis here, very aggressive player. And that kind of. This guy's closed down recently, so this open is like a little bit out of the blue, so I don't really want to call. I could turn this hand to free bet, but that would be quite good. But you can see, would have been pretty sick. We might have got there, sure, but I don't think we would have got to. We wouldn't have got to that point because he would have just reshipped over our free bet. And then if we'd have flatted, he'd have jammed, he'd have called, and we'd have folded. So unless we were just going to re-jam 30 big blinds with Jack Queen, that would have been great fun because we'd have 350k now. But we didn't do that.
I'm happy with our play.
We just spiced our cauliflower, guys, and that isn't a euphemism. I haven't been spicing my cauliflower in that way, with my cock.
Sorry about that language. So this is what, so we've got cauliflower, we've put a bit of some spice.
This time Gary Masala, our good friend Gary, we put that in and it's going to be delicious. Okay. What's this? Oh, we don't want to be almost folding anything. No! Okay, good. That was bad that we left it that late. So sorry, guys. I just need to eat, and I'm hungry. I hope you can understand hunger. The need to eat. We need to scope Rudeness or Rodinho, but we'll probably do that in the break rather than go out of zone now. This looks, you know, unintentionally strong. I was just very late to it, guys. I wasn't trying to tank hustle with aces. But you see how sometimes these things do affect how people see the game. You know, they'll be like, oh, I'll just make a smart fold or whatever, and actually you've made a bad fold. This guy's probably made a good fold, a good call, and now he's hit. That's what he should do. So, you know, he's got a worse hand at this point. But it's 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. He's got a bloody straight now, we've lost. But that's not the end of the world, because that can come down here now. And then we can really focus in on this final table. Which I want to do, obviously, after I've eaten some spiced curry. We're still trying to gamble and make chips in that one. So we rejam. We do lose another flip. But we'll just rebuy and keep going and hope to win one at some point. Excellent, so we've made it to another break. We're still live though. We've got pretty much the most as much as we've actually had. 24 at 31. We've got 400 guaranteed. Obviously, we want to win the 17k, please. We've been quite tight, obviously. Look at our 50 hands, 8-2. Oh boy, we've been tight. I know that's sad. But we're just trying to adjust. When you're playing against better players, I think fundamentally it's okay to be a bit tighter. We would quite we would quite like to have a table change for the three-handers, so we can kind of reset our tightness in the eyes of people. This table is actually pretty tough now. This guy is like, he's a spot on the table, but he's still a handful. He's very aggressive. Three decent reggae players all gonna do their thing. Lynx seems like a very decent play. The hands he's played, he seems aggressive. So we'll go maybe aggressive at holes, but thinking maybe he's better than that. Rudum, I'm not sure. Nemkis is a very good player right next to us, so we have to kind of factor that in, though. He's probably gonna view us as tight now, seeing us being tight, so maybe we can get things through him. Just trying to exploit how they think about us and how they view us. No, guys, my colour scheme stays. It's been fine for the last few hours. What is the problem now about my colour scheme? What factor has tipped it over? It seems unfair.
Feeling strong, we're feeling good. What we got? 10 seconds, man. 10 seconds left, leg.
I cannot believe it. 10 seconds leak? 10 seconds left leak? Alright, so the blinds are going to love the slower increments. Back in the day, the increments weren't quite that slow. That's an improvement.
The disimprovement is the fact I don't win as much. Disimprovement. Not even a word.
So I guess he rejammed a Jack 10 suited. That's what the kids are doing these days, they're just shipping it in. I'm 33, mate. I don't need to. I do sometimes do that. But we're knitting it up, guys. We're 33 years old. We knit it up, but unashamedly.
Knit bag.
We're gonna do. We're gonna make it. We've got some lovely yogurt, and we're gonna get. We've got some mint leaves, and we're gonna make a kind of mint riata out of this raita. I don't know how you say it, guys. Riata, raita. I don't know. Mint raita. That sounds better. I always think it's the other one, and then do the other one, but it's wrong. So I don't know which one I think is the right one. Initially, it's quite hard to tell now. So these guys, you know, these are good rejam spots in general, but we have to have something worth doing, and this is a great play. This player definitely proving a handful. Interesting to see what's happening here. Oh. But it is low fat, this yogurt as well, so it's not too fattening for me. Play some football, you know. I'm allowed to eat some food. So stop judging me, okay? Stop judging me. I've got the personality to pull it off. It's okay. I can grow this body. Grow any direction I want. Up, down. I can't grow my height. So he's gone all in to the free bet. So he's kind of seeing through this what looked felt like a light free bet, and it was. So he's trying to play his best, but this guy at a higher level is like, I sense you're weak, or I just have it this time.
Which is another possibility.
Smell that, guys. Can you smell that? Give it a sniff. Go on. It's mint leaves.
I didn't do that previously, I just ate it.
Oh my god, we got Ace King and mint leaves. So we might just, we have to just try and open that one. And tight, we're gonna open. We could just open rip and get called by it. We got called by Ace Queen when we opened ripped the previous pot, you know? And so that can happen. We're going to get played back at just because we've been so tight, I think, sometimes. There we go. So this is pretty, I think this is pretty good news in general. We want to get Ace King in, we want to induce a 4-bet jam. Okay, here we go. I think he's going to fold. He's got the worst hand! Two for me! Two! Please hold! Yes! Yes! Give me those chips, man. Give me the chips, Nemkiss. You think you're hard, do you, Nemkiss? Or you're free betting. Oh, I'm so hard, look at me. Oh, I'm free betting all the time. But guess what? You just free bet a knit when you had Ace Queen. You should have flatted. You wouldn't have had that problem, but instead you've just given me all your money. So if you're watching, Nemkiss, good luck. Good luck in the tournament. 5 out of 30 now. Just doing it.
50 big blind.
Frankly, guys, Ace Queen offsuit is the hand I would choose for him to call with. I mean, it's just a great situation.
guys.
I'll just show you what I'm doing here. I've got the yogurt and I've put the mint in, you see. You just mix it up. Alright, and then suddenly, guess what you got? You got fresh mint in there. You got a mint reata or a reata. I always say the wrong one. I think it's the other one, and then do the other one, and it's the wrong one. So I don't know how that works, but there's your onion reata, reata. I don't know which one it is, actually, guys. I always say the wrong one and do the wrong one with the onion reata or the reata. Okay, tasty. Couple of different chutneys as well here. Classic mango chutney from this one, and then we've got this one, premium mango chutney. We've had before and we think it tastes quite nice, but it's got slightly, so we think this is the higher quality one. But this one is quite old, you know, like kind of, it's got that kind of a classic, it says classic, it's got that classic taste. What I think we have to call here. It's pretty good for us. He's going to see about 107, but he does tend to slow down. He might try and barrel us, but we're pretty happy overall to call here and to okay. Kind of a bad turn for us overall. I don't think he's going to barrel light. There we go. So. We're just going to check call the river now. He could have turned a jack and checked, but I think if he turns runner jack, pretty sick. So we're going to probably call a bet on the river. And, oh, what's going on? What did he have? He had ace 10, so we win that. Yes, guys, yes. Ship us even more money. We're 4 out of 29. We want to be a free time champion. Free time. Well, that's pleasing. My lord, would we like to make that final table? Wow, we've a long way to go though. So I feel like we want to get to the last 27, get to the last 18, the last 15. We're just going to take it bit by bit.
Not going to look too far ahead.
Alright, oh. Okay, we would have got that in. Let's hope we wouldn't have won. My god, we probably wouldn't have. Would we have won? No, I think this guy's. Oh. I think we would have lost, actually, anyway. So that's. Not that it matters. Let's not be results orientated. We have an 8 or a 9. We had an 8, we would have won! We would have won it all. We were going to press the button, and we didn't get there in time because we made a. Making a curry. So. You know, people sometimes question my judgment in these situations, and I tend to agree with them in this particular scenario. Why am I making a curry when I could win this life-changing amount? I'm not making it from scratch, mind you. I'm just trying to.
I'm just getting all my bits on a plate. This is ready.
Alright, what's going on? We put the poppadom in.
6 out of 28. Come on, guys. Last 27. Let's do it. Let's change tables a little bit as well. A horrible image on this table. 62 hands. 10-3. If I saw some of those stats, I'd be like, this dude is an absolute terrible nit. And that's probably what they all think of me. So we've just got to be aware of our image. We're basically an over-the-hill reg in their eyes. So guess what? This old timer's still got some moves. But as you can see, I haven't really done anything too groundbreaking. What I will do is, this is close to a good spot to open, but there's so many aggressive players playing aggressively right now at this late moment. We look like the tight spot, you know, so we're gonna, as you saw, this guy 3-bet called with ace-queen. It's not like they're just adjusting their ranges like in a sensible way. So we, again, I think we would definitely, probably, you know, I think in normal circumstances we would open here. But we're just being a little bit nitty. Just wanting to keep going. Value our tournament life for sure. Got here. Offsuit ace-six. Again, we've got a good sort of image to open. I'm aware of that, guys. You're probably telling me that, but we're going to be really tight in early position. These guys are good. When we're playing, guys, we're playing, you know. We've got our hand playing. We ain't speculating. We're not marginalising. We're playing. This caramelization guy, you know, he's got. Oh, we're last 27 now, so we haven't changed tables. That's a shame. Again, it's quite a standard thing to call there, especially if his range is a bit wider. But playing out of position, so we're just going to be a bit careful. And it's going to be okay. I don't think we need to be too upset about what we're doing and feeling bad. Nice to eat at this time, and then we're nicely loaded with food for the rest of the grind. It's all about this tournament, the grind today. About deep run, sexy deep run, about a two-time champion with a dream who likes to play quite tightly, but it's still a nice dream. So again, we're just basically, Nemkes is a really tough player. He's going to own us a lot. We're going to have to I just want to avoid that. I do, guys, sue me. It's going to be almost ready now, guys. It's going to be absolutely delicious.